It's ridiculously early in the morning, and we're on the Columbia River at Longview to take part in the annual phenomenon known as the Wobbler fishery. Every summer, thousands of boats up and down the river line up with hopes of catching fall Chinook, and just about everyone is using a wobbler, which is basically a flat piece of metal formed and shaped to create the perfect wobble, which when fished correctly, can be amazingly effective. Probably the most popular type of wobbler is the Simon, and today we're on the water with David Hawken of Hawken Fishing that produces the Simon Wobbler, and RJ Herzman, who runs One Arm Bandit Guide Service. Also on board is a crew ready to spring into action at any moment. Those who have mastered the art of wobbler fishing tend to be very secretive, but the good thing about lure manufacturers is that they want you to catch fish. So today we're going to learn exactly how to put more fish in the boat during wobbler time.
Again, we're going to flatten it out. That is the perfect wobble right there. You don't get any better than that.
And then we'll head upstream to the mouth of the Klickitat for some bonus salmon fishing. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television.
Hey, Leah, come here.
The sun has finally risen, and 10-year-old Leah Hawken, who's been taking a well-earned nap, is about to fight in the first fish of the day. Her dad, David Hawken, runs Hawken Fishing, which manufactures the Simon Wobbler, which is the cause of this early morning commotion.
Real bad. There you go. You got it?
Yeah, he's just about here. When he gets up there, just reel right down to that little green bead for me, okay?
Okay.
Yep, she knows. Oh, that's a dandy.
That is a really nice fish.
Okay, rest him up. There you go. He's not ready yet. He took all your line back, didn't he? That's okay. Is he done running yet?
Doing a great job, kiddo.
Thank you. I want that, see that bead down there? Keep reeling until it's all the way up here, okay? Give RJ a chance to get them.
Straight out that side if you can.
Keep reeling. There you go. He's not quite done yet. That's 25 pounds at least. That's a beautiful fish. That is a beauty. Okay, Leah, there you go, stop. Okay. Well. That would be a fish that's not quite ready to come in yet.
I kept that on.
I know, you did good. Now you gotta reel it all back in. Good job. Keep going. A little more, Leah.
Right underneath the boat.
Okay. Okay. Rod tip up. Walk backwards. Just keep reeling, keep reeling. Okay, there you go, that's okay. Bring him back a little bit. There you go. Good job.
I think that one's got to go at least 25. Well, 22 anyway. Yeah, get over.
Another beautiful fall Chinook caught on a Simon Wobbler. It's day before Labor Day weekend?
Yeah. August 31st, peak of the season.
It is that time of year.
Welcome back to the Columbia River, where we have our first fish in the boat, but we're not the only ones catching fish this morning.
Devin, kick us loose. Rob's out. Devin, kick us loose.
So right now, Bob over here is one of our pro staff guys, has a huge influence on stuff we come out with as far as patterns. And he's got a what looks to be a really nice Chinook on right now. So we'll hope they get it in and get some pictures of it and see what they're using. I believe that was on that number 11 green dot.
The water temperature's up right now in the river. It's around 67, 68 degrees. The fish have kind of gone off the bite for bait this far up river. So we switch kind of to the metal lures with the Simons. They're extremely versatile in this fishery. They can fish anywhere from really slow water to really fast water. Especially in deep water, they're excellent lures. We can, generally it's about a 5 foot dropper and about a 5 foot leader is what we go with. There's a variety of colors that can match just about any water color, water temperature that you could possibly want in this fishery. As far as then they can be fished anywhere from all the way upstream to all the way downstream, they've been effective pretty much everywhere.
It is a double. You got a double.
Let's see if you can do it. We got Angler's Guide Service over here fishing Simons. It looks like they got a double header going. Been a little bit slow this morning, but it is picking up rapidly. So we know that is the first double I've seen this year. So it's nice to see the fish coming in as strong as they are. So he's going to have quite the okay, decided enough's enough. So they're just going to take the one fish and they're going to go with it.
We've got about two different styles of rods today. We've got some 8 foot rods that are out the back, and then we've got a 9 foot rod in the middle. We've got and then we've got 9 foot rods forward to kind of give us a little bit wider spread as we go up to make cover a little bit more water. And then we've staggered all of our leads on the way up, so we're fishing a little bit different, so we don't get anything tangled up. We've got right now we're running 16 ounces on the back. We're running a 20 in the middle, and then we're running 20s up front, so we can make basically a wall, make two different walls of lures as they come up. So as those fish push up, we can kind of cover a whole wide area with a couple of walls, and as they run into it, we're hoping to get bit at the best we can.
Same one, Bob.
Doctor's in the house. Let us go. Let us go.
What you see in there is Bob's tape job. It's we nicknamed it Dr. Death. It is quite possibly one of the more productive patterns that we've had up till these new paint jobs we've come out with. So that's his pet pattern. He's had it. He's the one that developed it. There's a few out there on the market, but that's the guy that came up with it. And they got a beautiful little Chinook right there, and we're going to get started again, see what we can do to get some more fish in the boat. You'll also notice that there was some bead chains on that coming off the back of that. And in the real heavy current, some guys will cut the rings off the back of the Simon, bead chain them back, put on their treble hooks or whatever if they want to use side washes. And you'll notice that on his in particular, he's doing that to get the a certain wobble the way he likes it. He likes his where the back end of the wobbler kind of swishes back and forth. I like mine where it's really in line and real tight. So it's personal preference, and we'll see who ends up with more fish. So what you're looking at here is when the number 11 here on the right-hand side, the chartreuse green dot, what you're seeing is the blade is almost tilting all the way up on edge, whereas the other one here with the chartreuse green with the dark green stripes on the top and bottom has more of a swing to it. It's just personal preference. Sometimes the fish like it real tight, like I was telling you earlier, that I personally enjoy fishing, whereas the other one, Bob, likes that swishing feel. That was the pro staff person that we talked about earlier. Just two different styles of fishing, both very, very effective. Let me guess.
Doctor's in the house, brother.
We have roughly 18 to 20 ounces of lead today. So what you're going to have to do with the wobblers to make them spin right, as you can see, we've flattened it out a little bit. What that entails is usually these things come out of the package and they look like this. You can see the bend in the blade. For 8 ounces of lead, 10 ounces of lead, this is fine. But up in the, as the water starts to push, you can see how we flatten this thing out now. Don't mess with the wings in the back here. Don't touch those. This front bill is what that's the secret sauce to what we've got going here. So we'll have a 5 foot leader, and then off the leader, we'll have a 5 foot dropper to the lead weight. You can see we're just about using cannonball type stuff here to stay down. But it's 5 and 5, that's the rule. That's what you're looking for. Nice switching side to side. We're gonna catch them again on this one right here. You watch.
Welcome back to the Columbia River at Longview. I'm Justin Wolf. It's late summer and most anglers have used the last of their bait and are now anchoring up the fish wobblers, which have been effective for many years, but there's always room for improvement.
So what we come out with this year is a couple of new sizes in the Simons. Now when I say sizes, I actually mean weights. We have the original Simon, so one we've been fishing for years. We're just here in the last little bit. Now, I think we have 52 colors, 56 colors now of these. We've added to it a hammered series, which is also heavy. Our best-selling patterns, most productive, we've gone with a hammered. And then we also have a heavy that is the same as the Simon that we originally had, except for it's in an 032 gauge, which is about a third heavier. And anywhere from 8 ounces to 20 ounces like you're seeing today, this is what we're fishing out here, and it's proven incredibly effective. Throughout the day, what we'll do is we'll change out Simons, different colors, different patterns, try whatever we can do to make sure that we're covering every aspect of it. Typical fisherman type stuff. If we have it in the boat, we want to use it. So changing out, again, this is a Lemon Joy scrub. Just get yourself as cleaned up as you can. And this is actually one that we've bead chained back a little bit. This is just to help with the current right now. We're up to 24 ounces of lead. So with that, the extra bead chain here is gonna help it swim better in the water and hopefully do the trick. And then we're gonna grab ourselves some bloody tuna here now, get it scented up, and away it goes, and hope for the best. Yeah, the Lemon Joy thing, some people believe in it, some people don't, but I assure you of this. Everybody gets in the boat, everybody washes their hands first thing in the morning, and it seems to make a difference for us. And then the Bloody Tuna, Procure Super Gels, it's, again, one of those things that I think every guide boat's got it, personal boats, I think everybody has it. Great stuff.
Absolutely, absolutely. It, there's days that between washing your hands and doing everything right, taking care of your lures, and using some of the Procure bait scents, it can make a difference between having a very bad day and a very good day.
Again, we're using this one here has 16 ounces of lead. Let's put it down the bottom. Walking it back. RJ, where do you want these as far as footage behind the boat?
That one was at 72 feet last time when we got that fish.
Tell you what, 72
feet. So we'll get it right back in the same spot, and maybe there might be a small ledge or something down there that he was running on. So we'll keep that one fishing right in the same spot.
Yeah. Well, these Shimano Dakota reels, I mean, they got the line counters on them. It is nice to have.
Yep.
Yep.
Dad, do you want me to reel up this one?
If you would, that'd be great. Hand out front, please.
Yeah, as the tide starts really running out, we usually get a little bit of a lull in the action. As it really runs hard, those fish push a little lower to the bottom. Now that this tide's starting to slack up a little bit, I expect that the bite's going to really pick up. And we've got one on here. It looks like a really nice fish. Hopefully we can land it, and it'll be a really nice upriver bright.
That could be a tule. Yeah, down here in the lower river, you're going to see some what we call tules. That is the given name for them. It's the Chinook that actually spawned in the lower tributaries here, the Cowlitz, the Lewis, Kalama, things like that. Upriver brights, they're heading over the dam. You'll see here in a moment, we can get it up close to the boat, a little darker fish. The meat's white. It's not, they're still great fish, but they're not the preferred fish that we're looking for. We may just cut this one free. Great fighting fish. Not a great eating fish. If he's hooked, I can just take him out in the water and just, if he's gonna try to roll him out, he's got all three. Hang on just a second. Let me just see if I can. We got real warm water right now. And I said the stress on the fish. We're gonna do everything we can to make sure this thing's ready to go before we got him out. Here he goes. Oh, Well, Bob caught another one, and he did not limit his boat on Dr. Death, thank God, because I'd never hear the end of it. So he's got another one on. I think that was that number 40 that we got on this morning. He made short work of that, didn't he?